the majority of the economy, and as a result, everybody is affected, not to a different extent. So what explains the differences in the first world of foreign trade? So smaller countries usually depend more on foreign trade than larger countries. So Poland is less affected by trade short than, say, the Baltics or the Czech Republic or Hungary. We also do not depend very much on exports of commodities like oil. So we are not affected by boom and bust in oil prices like Russia. But we do not depend so much on exports of metallurgical products, so we do not depend, we are not hit as much as we can. So this is one channel. The second channel is financial. Now, countries of our region, fortunately, have not invested in sophisticated U.S. securities, as distinct from, say, some banks in Germany, in Switzerland, not to mention Britain. So this channel is not, fortunately, it's not operating in the case of Central and Eastern Europe. We have not invested, to my knowledge, in, say, mortgage-based securities. It's very sophisticated. But the problem was that there was the growth of credit during last years was very rapid. To some extent financed from abroad. And where it was especially rapid, in the Baltics, to some extent in Ukraine, in Hungary because especially foreign denominated credit. And the more boom you have, the more bust the experience. In Poland, this growth of credit was not as rapid as in the Baltics or in Ukraine or in Hungary. And the third difference is fiscal policy. Now, almost in every country, fiscal policy was too expansionary. But it was especially expansionary, especially back in Hungary for the last years. So the more fiscal boom you have, the more fiscal bust you have. So these three factors, and because of the differences in these three factors, there are huge differences in the forecasted GDP growth in Central and Eastern Europe. Who is going to be most affected in the short run?